In de noordwestelijke hoek van die provincie Natal, in de Republiek van Zuid-Afrika, liggen een reeks bergen bekend als die Drakensbergen. Tussen die randjes aan de voet van die reeks is een berg met een plat kruin wat genoemd wordt Majuba, Zulu voor die heuvel van duiven. Hier in die vallei en op die kruin van Majuba is oorlog gemaakt tussen die burgers van die Zuid-Afrikaanse Republiek en die macht van die Victoriaanse Britse leer. Dit was de jaar 1881. Engeland had die Kaapkolonie en Natal beheer. Een paar jaar vroeger, in 1877, had hij Transvaal geannexeerd. Politieke misdrijven en beloftes wat niet nagekomen is niet, het de inwoners van Transvaal ontevreden gemaakt. Daar is besluit om al recht als onafhankelijke natie te laten geld en om te vechten om de gehate annexatie, wat zekere politici in Engeland op willen afgedwongen het, tot niet te maken. Voor de Britten was die slag een ramp. Hier bij Majuba had Engeland zijn vernederendste neerlaag geleid. En hier, in die schaduw van die berg, lei boer en Brit niet ver van elkaar. Hier die gevecht, die Transvaalse Vrijheidsoorlog, zou die geschiedenis van Zuid-Afrika drastisch veranderen.
Oma sê, 'n knippie sout op die pit sal die kers langer laat brand. As hy klaar gebrand het, moet jy loop. Wat is dit, Dirk? Wat is dit?
Ek is bekommerd, Lena. Daar gaan moeilikheid wees.
Die Engelse?
Wat het van hulle beloftes geword? Waar is ons vryheid? Hulle 3 jaar gelede beloof, hulle het niks nagekom. As daar oorlog kom, dan moet ek gaan. Ons kom volgende maand by Paardekraal, by mekaar, almal sal daar wees. En ons gaan gewapen.
Wanneer gij zult uittrekken tot den strijd tegen uw vijanden en zult zien paarden en wagenen, 1 volk meerder dan gij, zo zult gij niet hen vrezen, want de Heer uw God is met u, die u uit Egypte land heeft opgevoerd. Hoort Israël, gij lieden, zijt heden na aan den strijd tegen uw vijanden, want het is de Heere, uw God, die met u gaan om voor u te strijden tegen uw vijanden, om u te verlossen.
Die moeilijkheid het dus gekom. Het moest kom. Kinders, julle pa is te gauw dood. As hy gelewe het, kon julle nou almal saam opgesaal het en gaan veg het.
Ek glo nie aan oorlog nie.
En aardig dat jy dit sê, Philippus, jy wat die helfte van jou lewe geveg het. En dis hulle wat die wind gesaai het en hulle wat die warrelwind sal maai nou dat die dag gekom het.
Ja, ek het my lewe deurgeveg. En wat het ek daarvoor gekry? Dis wat ek gekry. Letsels, nogmaals letsels. Vriende dood. My seuns gesnevel. Wrachtig, dit is oor oorlog. Maar ek so alleen is.
Dis oor jy oud word.
Te oud, denk jy. Jy denk as tyd dat ek doodgaan. Jy en jou klein seuns Rolf en Louis. Maar ek sal nie doodgaan om julle tevrede te stel nie. Ek sal nie doodgaan om enige een te plezier nie. Hierin ten minste sal ek myself plezier.
Oupa, moenie so praat nie.
Ons sal die Engels in die see indryf. Ons sal hulle uitjaag.
Jy sal hulle uitjaag. Jy en wie nog? Nie dat ek die Engels te lief het nie. Maar ek haat oorlog. Dit verniel die land.
Moet ons, dat ons die Kaapkolonie word, waar een eerlijke man om nie vir die parlement verkiesbaar mag stel, omdat hy nie Engels kan praat nie. Waar hy, wanneer hy opgeroep word om by een commando aan te sluit, moet dien onder een man wat hy nie gekies het nie, en wie hy gaan vertrouwen het nie. Ons wacht tot hierdie dinge hier gebeur. Ons leefwijze en ons godsdienst word door vreemdelingen bespot. Ons land ontheilig.
Rolf is reg, maar ek wens het kon anders wees.
Dis omdat jy my sister Lena wil trouw. Jy sal dit liever doen as om te veg.
Ons sal allemaal veg as jylle dit wil hê. Dirk is gereed. En ek ook.
Rolf het nog altyd die Engelse gehad. Hy wil oorlog hê, hy bid daarvoor. Niemand weet hoekom hy so hatig is nie.
Dis alles deel van wat ouma hom geleer. Gaan al vir jare aan. Sy haatdraand het hierdie vooroordeel. Politieke praatjies, argumente. En nou gaan belasting. Hoe Hoe kan mens een land bestuur sonder belasting? As daar een oorlog is, wen of verloor, ek waarsku julle, sal het een ramp.
Lena! Jy huil, Lena.
Ek huil nie. Ek is verkoue.
Jy moet nie huil nie.
Jy moet terugkom. Beloof dat jy sal terugkom.
Wie sê ek gaan weg?
Dan gaan oorlog kom. Jy weet het. Hoekom skeer jy die gek met my?
Pie af jou trane.
O, Dirk.
Pa? Oma? Dirk?
Wat is dit, Boetie?
Daar's iets verkeerd, oma.
Ja. Iets is verkeerd as man sy huis moet verlaat.
Pa? Gaan Dirk ook?
Ja, jy moet jou ouma en kleinsus mooi oppas.
As ek nie blind was nie, kon ek ook gegaan het, nee pa. Daar's ander oudjies wat jonger as ek is wat daar sal wees.
Ons gaan net na 'n vergadering toe. Ons sou altyd hierdie vergadering gehou het, maar nou sou dit 'n bietjie vroeër gemaak.
Wat pa, bandeliere gebeur na 'n vergadering?
Pa? Die pere is gereed. Rolf en Louis wacht by die kruispad.
Wees jy so, jylle sal sien, daar gaan oorlog wees. Ons wil het hee,
alle jong burgers wil het hee.
Jong snuiters moet niks anders as hulle lewe om te verloor nie. Hulle mag het hulle, maar hulle is nie die nasie nie. Ons ry paarde kraal toe om te sien wat die nasie wil hee.
Ons sal sien. Wat denk jy, Louis?
As allemaal net regheid wil praat, sal daar nooit oorlog wees nie.
En Rolf?
Rolf is anders.
Rumblings of rebellion, Sir Owen. At this moment, the Burghers ride to Powderkraal to form their own government. Should there be an uprising, we have not sufficient forces to contain them.
I cannot conceive what can have so suddenly caused the Burghers to act as they have. Instruct Colonel Anstruther at Leidenburg to proceed to Pretoria with reinforcements immediately.
Sir.
There is not two opinions. Die volk besluit, ons moet kies, vernedering of oorlog, vrede of oorlog, vryheid of oorlog.
Hoe sal u stem, oom Groot-Dirk?
Ek is teen oorlog, maar ons het nie 'n keuse nie. God help ons as dit oorlog is.
Daar moet 'n kans vir vrede wees.
Binnekort sal hulle optrek. Gou sal die nasie in die veld wees. Dit moet oorlog wees. Ek kan dit op die manne se gesigte sien. Hoe hulle loop, hoe hulle opsaal.
En die naam van die volk van die Suid-Afrikaanse Republiek verklaar ons dat hierdie klipstapel op Paardekraal sal staan as 'n vryheidsmonument. En ons maak bekend dat ons drie manskap, S.J.P. Kreur, M.W. Pretorius en P.J. Joubert, op die 13de December 1880 gekies is om die voorlopige regering waar te neem.
Dis al 'n week, 'n hele week, en nog niks nuus nie.
Jy verstaan nie, die dinge neem tyd. Hulle vorm 'n nuwe regering by Heidelberg, onder Paul Kreur, Joubert en Pretorius. Kroyer ry Potchefstroom toe met sy kommando om die proklamasie te laat druk.
Is die vergadering te Paardekraal verby?
Miskien. Hulle sê dis nou nie meer 'n kwestie van enkelinge nie, maar van nasies. Jy lyk siek.
Nee, ek is nie siek nie.
As ek sê jy is siek, dan is jy siek. En dis al. Jy is jonk en verlief. En dis genoeg om enige meisie te laat siek voel. Ek dink ek moet jou goeie pergasie gee. Maar moenie vir jou ouma sê nie. Sy is dom. En sy weet niks van kruie af nie. Jy sal hier 'n bietjie moet uitsit. Jy sal as jy getroud is. Trou is vir 'n vrou soos milies vir 'n perd. Die tevredenheid maak hulle vet. Ek het vir jou iets. Een hangertjie. Dit het aan my eerste man se moeder behoort.
O, dit is prachtig, Tante Marthe, dankie.
Jy lyk prachtig. Ja?
Hulle het 'n brief gebring van Mrs. Brenner.
Stuur Carlos het. Ek moet hom praat. Carlos, as jy so gewoond op die veld leef, dat jy nie weet waarvoor 'n hek daar is nie, dink jy ek wil al die losloperdiere van die dorp in my tuin laat wei?
Die brief. Die baasie is siek. Sal die mevrou kom?
Ja, sê vir hulle kom. Frans, Frans die perre. Die karre die perre. Hartloop, moet jy daar staan nie, en maak toe my hek.
Die dag nie, Brian, hoe gaan dit met jou vrou? Is sy nou beter?
Baie goed, dankie mevrou, gaan met jou.
Goed, dankie, tot ziens.
What's happening here?
Oh, some English troops are expected here today. And Mr. Brenner thought it would be nice to invite the officers and a few friends for dinner.
There may be war.
I do not believe there'll be war. The English are too strong. But thanks for coming anyway.
Good morning, Mr. Brenner.
Good morning to you.
I'd like to see them. I've never met a red coat before.
Won't you join us?
Thank you.
Moet ik die kookwagen terughalen van Charlie Brenner?
Dat is niet bevallen, Jans.
Kan ook niks recht doen.
Drink it, Charlie.
No.
Drink it. It'll make you well.
I want to see the soldiers. I want to see them.
If you drink the medicine, you can see them.
Promise?
Yes.
The child must sleep.
I'll stay with him. He's so excited about the soldiers.
See that he keeps covered. He must sweat.
Lena, ek het gedink jy moet vannacht by my oorblij. Mevrou Brenner het my na die ete toegenooi vanavond en ek wil hy, jy moet saamgaan. Jy kan jou nuwe rok aantrek.
Ek? Saam met die Engelse soldaten? Nooit. Ek sal bly om Charlie Brenner te help oppas, maar ek sal nooit saam met die Engelsman eet nie.
Ach, julle meisjes maak my vies. Julle is so dom. Jy is een mooi meisje. Begryp jy nie, mans? Hou daarvan om met mooi meisjes te praat nie. En dink net. Jy kan dan iets hoor wat vir ons mense van belang gaan wees. Machtig, jy kan niks oorkom nie. Hulle is nie duivels nie.
Wil dat maar dat hy, ek moet met hulle praat, saam met hulle eet? Ek, een spion?
How's the boy?
Much better. He slept for 3 hours. Marta, isn't it wonderful? The colonel says there will be no war. He says the burghers will not stand up to regular troops.
You're quite right, colonel. Our men won't stand up to fight you. It's not their custom. They'll be behind every rock, bush and tree. And from there they'll pick off your men like chickens.
Does Martha?
We do not want war, ma'am.
Do you think we want it?
Where are you going? I hear you've come from Leidenburg.
We're moving to Pretoria. We're going to concentrate there till this is all over.
Do you think there'll be a war?
Of course not. How can there be? The Transvaalers have no troops.
No. We have nothing like your soldiers.
It's discipline that counts. But don't think I don't admire your people. We all do. In fact, our Prime Minister, Mr. Gladstone, never believed in the annexation of the Transvaal right from the start.
Is that so? Then why are you ready to fight?
We are soldiers. Oh, would you care for a glass of punch or some cake?
Thank you. Some cake and coffee. Oh, thank you.
Tell me, are you married?
No, are you?
No, we do not marry till we get a captaincy.
A captaincy? What is that?
That's a captain.
You mean you have to be a certain age and serve so long before you can marry?
Yes, that's about it.
That is just like the Zulus. Only the warriors, when they have fought in many battles, can wear rings round their heads and marry. I didn't know it was the same with the English. Did you learn it from them?
No, we did not learn it from them. It's a matter of money.
Then it is like the Zulus. Do you buy your women with cows? Do you give your father-in-law 10 cows for his daughter?
Of course not. But women are expensive. They have to have things. Clothes, servants, houses, horses, carriages, and hundreds of things to make them happy. And then half the time they aren't.
What is the matter with them? Can't Englishmen make their wives happy?
Pleasant there. I see you picked a lovely flower.
Yes, yes, sir.
Are you married?
Eh? I know.
Excuse me, sir.
He said captains could marry, and he said you were a captain.
Yes, I am a captain. But I'm not married.
I don't understand it at all. You're a strange people.
There's one starling, 2 finches, and 1 bulbul.
Hello?
This is the regimental doctor, Captain Lang.
How do you do?
Are you married, Captain Lang?
No, I'm not. Not yet, anyway.
But you are a captain.
Yes, I am.
Then I give up.
I beg your pardon, young lady.
That's all right, Captain. It's nothing. How's Charlie?
Better, thank you, Lena. Do you know what I've done?
No. What have you done?
I've given the doctor my birds. He's taken them with him to Pretoria.
You like birds, Captain?
Yes, it's a hobby of mine. I'm an ornithologist. It's a good hobby when you travel the world, as I do.
Ah, Vicar. I hear you're going on leave.
Yes.
How long will you be away?
About 6 or 7 months.
Good.
Excuse me, Colonel.
Yes, Mr. Brenner?
I've just had bad news, Colonel. There's a commando between you and Pretoria. They've come to stop you.
Stop me? I have my orders. I'm going on.
They mean business, Colonel?
They do they? Well, so does the 94th, by gad.
Colonel, we know them well. Many of them are dear friends of ours. I must warn you that there has been open talk of war. The people have refused to pay their taxes. Need I remind you of the Zadenhout wagon affair?
Farmers on horseback. A nation of deerstalkers.
If by that remark you mean hitting a running buck at 400 yards, then yes, deerstalkers indeed.
Madam, I have 248 trained men. English soldiers.
But Colonel...
I'm sorry, Mr. Brenner. They won't stop us. It's a lot of fuss about nothing. In a month, everything will have settled down.
Geef jou baie hierdie boodskap. Die 94ste regiment marseer na Pretoria.
Hoeveel manskappe?
248, insluitende offisiere. Sê vir hom dis ek wat jou gesê het, en dat hulle gaan veg as hulle gekeer word. Hulle sal die stroom pronkel spruit, morgenoggend omtrent 11 uur.
Die Heere weet, ons wil nie veg nie, maar hulle dwing ons.
Dis vir jou baie en die Almagtige.
Geer die vir die Engelse officier.
Weg, commandant.
Battalion! Hop!
Message from Commandant Jubermania. You have 2 minutes to make up your mind.
My compliments to your Commandant. I intend to cross Bronco Strait and then march on to Pretoria.
Thank you.
They got us. Listen, they got us. The whole bloody lot.
Take him inside.
The colonel sent me. He said, take a horse and ride like hell. Go to Brenner's store. Tell him what's happened. Ask for help. Blankets. Bandages. My God, they're giving it to us, proper. Are you going?
We will go. What happened?
Well, we was marching along, and then we saw them. It was on top of a hill. One of them came down with a white flag and told us to stop, but the colonel wouldn't stop. The 94th don't stop when they're marching, sir. And then they began to shoot. Dozens of them, all hidden. It ain't proper, sir. All me mates is there, laying in the bleeding sunshine. It ain't proper. The whole road running with blood.
We must inspan the cart. Tell the other women to bring linen, bandages, blankets.
I'll take my cart. We can call at the house for medicines.
Do you know where this place is?
They must have caught them at Watercress Drift. Bronco Sprite, you know. Master. What fools the redcoats are to have been caught like that.
To come. We are now the enemy.
This is man's work. It is for this we bear them. Yet, where men are hurt, you'll find women.
Wait, Kelly, how do you spell Bronco Sprite?
Wait, Kelly!
Yes, Martha.
What for?
I've no idea.
Where is the colonel?
In a tent. They say he is seriously wounded.
You were say you'll be a lady prisoner. Yay, Rolf van die ander. Doe je next night on by Mustard's commando in the side.
Dan moet ons groet, pa.
Ja. Voorspoed.
Tot ziens, Dirk.
Tot ziens, Louis.
Wel, jong. Ons van die prisoners Heidelberg toe. Ga lekker wees my Engels aan te jaag.
Mans wat ander mans soos vee aanjaag.
Ek denk jy is a dwaas, Dirk.
Hoor hier, Rolf. Jy gaan eendag my swaar wees. Maar dis nie te sê dat jy so met my kan praat nie. Jy kan dink wat jy wil, maar bly om vaders naam stil.
First, a toast that you will not drink to Chabert. To Her Majesty the Queen. God bless her. Another toast to the ladies and others of Brennerstorp, whom I thank from the bottom of my heart.
Colonel. I'll drink to your queen, but in our fashion. Here's to Queen Victoria. May she live a long time and take her soldiers from our land.
dearest Dorcas. Indeed.
Gaan jy het?
Wie die prisoniers tel?
Nee. Het hulle al water gekry?
Water? Het is gelukkig om lewendig te wees. As ek...
As jy wat, Rolf?
Niks.
Sir. Sir?
Who is that?
Sergeant Hopkins. I heard what you said to the other guard. Couldn't we get some water for my men, sir? We'd be much obliged.
How can I get you water and leave you unguarded?
Well, perhaps I could stand guard for you.
How do I know that you wouldn't run away?
I give you my word, sir.
I've no bucket.
Well, there's a milk bucket here.
You swear in the name of the Almighty God. Swear.
I swear in the name of the Almighty God that I won't escape myself and I won't allow anyone else to escape.
Bring the bucket.
Daar wag staan Dirk. Wat doen jy?
Hulle moet kry water vir die pere.
Die pere het klaar gesê.
Wel, myne het nog nie.
Jy het die prisoniers onbewaak gelos. Kan ek jou help?
Nee.
Ek denk sy nog een bietjie gaan slaap. Ek sy in 2.5 uur aflos. En Dirk. Jy beter weer kom water af. Daar is nie nabij genoeg vir 50 man nie. Goeienacht.
Nacht, Willem.
Your host, the farmer, has kindly lent us a wagon for the wounded that cannot go on. But I say, there will be no oxen. Now pick up those yokes and chains. Anyone who disobeys, I will shoot. You others can push. Take the wheels. We're off on the great trek from the English to Heidelberg. Trek!
Hou op! Rolf, dis genoeg. Laat die prisoniers inval. Hulle moet marcheer.
Hey, hulle gehoor! Ha! Hey, wil die trek stop! Trek! Pull the wagon!
Hou op! Rolf, hoe kan jy so iets doen?
Ek sê hulle trek vir die baan!
En ek sê hulle marcheer!
Thank you.
Los dat, Rolf, jy sal hom doodmaak. Ek sê los dat. Laat die prisoniers inval, ons gaan aan.
Daar, het is klaar. Is het niet prachtig, niet?
Ja, het is mooi. Maar jij hebt het niet goed klaargemaakt, niet?
Wel, ik kan niet zien, niet. Ik kan het voelen.
Hoe kan jij niet zien, niet, Boetie?
Ik weet niet. Maar het van mij gezegd voor ze gesterf het, dat dit God zijn wil is. Sy het gesê, ek kan meer sien as baie wat oë het. As ek nie blind was nie, sou ek nou saam met pa en Dirk gewees het.
Ek is bly jy het nie weggegaan nie, Boetie.
Hoekom?
Nou kan jy vir my sorg.
Katrein! Katrein! Stephanie is hier! Ruiter, bring die kas!
Stephanie, wat een heerlijke verrassing. Ons het jou eerst volgende week verwag.
Ek het vir Tante Klein geskryf. Kom naar die bos. Jy weet hoe draai hulle. Dag, Lena.
Dag, Stephanie.
Hoe gaan dit met my sister?
Dit gaan goed met mamie, dankie. Sy was net jammer dat sy nie kon saamkom nie.
Ek het amper vergeet, arme vrou, om so jong te wees en 'n man te verloor. Voetog.
Voetog sy voet. Weet jylle, sy is een van die rijkste vrouwens in die kolonie. Hy vraag geld en eiendomme en 4 plaas nagelaat. Ek moes so'n man gehad het.
Kom, Stephanie.
Dankie.
Maar dis een mooi hangerkie, Stef.
Een seekaptein het van die Indiese eilande afgebring. Een vriend van mamie. Hy bring altyd vir ons geskenke. Sy, ivoor, parfum.
Parfum?
Ryk dan, Marte. En jou ryk? Op jou ouderdom behoort jy meer verstand te hee.
Dit ryk wonderlik. Ek sal daarvan hou om so te ryk.
Jy ryk soos een muis.
Dis muskusgeur. Seldsame delikate parfum wat van 'n bokkie verkry word. Ek het al daarvan gehoor. Dit word van die agterend van 'n bok gemaak.
Hoe dames gebruik dit?
Natuurlik. Hoe dames kan miskien daarvan hou om soos 'n bok te ruik. Maar vir jou om soos een te ruik, sal nie van jou 'n hoe dame maak nie. Jy is 'n plaaskind, die dogter van Rudolf van Baffiansrivier. En dit lyk vir my, jy het nie baie verander van dat jy klein is. Kan dan Martha so met my praat? Ek het so ver gery om hier te kom kuier. Moenie ontsteld wees nie, kind. Ons is bly om jou te sien. Maak nie saak hoe sleg jy ry nie. Wat is dit? Oupa, wie anders?
Wat my keer, oupa? Oupa het beloof om nie die klok te lui en sê dit baie dringend is nie.
Obas?
Ja, Ryder?
Titus de Waardrijver, sy is al nie saam met ons gaan nie. Die oorlog is te sleg. Hy sê die Engelse skiet nie soos die bergers nie. Hulle skiet mis. En as hulle voor die Obas mis, dan skiet hulle daar voor Titus raak.
Sever, Titus! Ek kan maar sê...
Lena? Het jy gedroom? Jy slaap baie onrustig. Miskien is daar te veel komberse oor jou.
Nee. Ek is bang vir Dirk se onthalwe. Hoeveel zulke nachten zal dan nog wees?
Nee, me kommerd wees nie. Het gaan goed met Dirk. Vader het altijd gesê, geen nieuws is goeie nieuws.
Nee, wat, Stef? Ek sal liever van hom wil hoor. Luister net na die storm. Ek weet nie waarom my gedagtes heen te stuur nie. Noord, suid, oos of wes?
Wel, miskien gaan gedagtes in sirkels. Dit maak nie saak, watter kant toe jy hulle stuur nie.
Wie is jy?
Ek is Boedie van den Berg. Ek is Groot Dirk van Doornkloof se seun.
Hoe ver is dit na die opstal?
Omtrent 1/2 mijl met die pad langs. My ouma is daar.
Dankie.
Seen any men, boy?
I've seen nothing.
How long have you been here?
A long time.
You'll get nothing out of the boys, sir. They came this way, all right. Come on. Good morning, ma'am. We've been following a commando. 6 men. They were headed this way.
I'm afraid I can't help you, Captain.
Lieutenant, ma'am.
Oh, I see. Well, we haven't had any visitors for weeks. Not since my son-in-law and grandson went to fight the...
I quite understand, ma'am. Well, I'm sorry to have troubled you. Perhaps they took to the hills. Their horses were tired. I reasoned that maybe they would have stopped at the house. Just a thought.
Sir.
Ouma, die oomie met die pere wil die kie koffie hê.
That's a mooi pop. Do you like popper?
Yeah.
Would you like a nieuwe pop? Better than this one? What is your naam?
Klein Johanna.
Well, Klein Johanna. Would you like nog a pop? A really big one?
Yeah.
Then say for me, who is achter die huis? Is it a oomie with a gun and pere?
Yeah, and I have a coffee.
Come, we'll go and see.
Mama? Klein Johanna? Mama!
Soek jou Boers se kommando.
Hy is iewers in die suide, naby Coldstream. Daar's baie kommandos daar. Die Engelse generaal is in die kamp by Mount Prospect. En nog meer troepe is op pad van India af.
Wie is hy, die Engelse kommandant?
Majoor generaal Sir George Pomeroy Colley, hoofkommissaris van Suidoos-Afrika.
Waarheen is jy op pad?
Rapporte vir Paul Kruger by Heidelberg. Tot ziens.
Onthou net, as ons van die pad afloop, sê vir my, as jy iemand sien, dan moet ons stop en hulle die pad vra. Kan jy my verstaan?
Ons gaan na Tante Katrein. Ons gaan na Tante Katrein.
Klein Johanna, het jy my gehoor? Verstaan jy?
Ja, Boetie, ons moet stop en vir iemand die pad vra.
I think someone's coming. You better take a look down the road. Be careful, eh?
Maybe it's our blooming army looking for us.
Have a ride, young fella.
Who are you?
Members of Her Majesty's forces. On leave, you might say. Isn't that right, Thomas?
That's right, sir. Going to the Free State on holiday.
What are you doing here, then?
Well, we're looking for a lift to the border.
Well, I'm sorry, but we're travelling the opposite way.
Are you now?
My pop! Give my pop!
I wouldn't try that again.
Blimey, blind.
You're wasting time. Get him off the cart. Hurry up, Marsh!
klaar. Nou sal ek...
Kom in, Jonas. Ja?
Oh, missus, iets het gebeur. Dit is Boetie, die klimbas van Doornkloof.
Waarvan praat jy?
Kom gou-gou, missus.
Daar het alweer iets gebeur. De commando's maak geweet en begin op de grens van Natal trek. Net vanmorgen het een van mijn eigen mensen mij vertel.
Hoe lang het ik nog oor? Moet ik mijn tijd morgen om naar jou te luisteren? Vertel mij.
Helle zei dat de Engels gaan sommer goede tans wel invallen. Helle gaan weg bij de Lijnsnek. Die plek ligt net onder de berg Majuba.
Commence the bombardment of Lang's Neck. Thank you. Order the 58th to withdraw.
Fraser, order the 58th to withdraw.
Sir.
Dag mevrouw, dames.
Jij komt van ver af.
Ja. Is dit die plaas mooi plaas?
Dit is ja.
Ek het nuus. Ek is gesê om te vra vir Philippus de Tooi.
Ek is sy vrou, jy kan me van my sê.
Daar is baie Engelse soldate dood mevrouw.
Jy het nuus van my kleinseuns.
Ja.
Het is slecht in dies. Ek weet het. Ek weet het al daar lang. Wat er een?
Al twee, mevrouw.
Ek het gesê, ek sal my seuns gee. En hulle seuns gee. Vir ons land. Vir ons ideale. Ja, ek het gesê dat ek hulle gewilliglik sal gee. En nou het die Here my woord onthou.
Hooray! Stand it! Hey!
Officers, non-commissioned officers, and men. I called you together this afternoon, being desirous of saying a few words to you. I wish everyone present to understand that the entire blame for today's repulse rests entirely upon me, and not on any of you. I congratulate the 58th Regiment on the brave and noble manner in which they fought today. We have lost many gallant men. I might add, however, that notwithstanding the loss of many troops, we've not lost one atom of the prestige of England. It is my duty to congratulate Major Brownlow on the gallant charge he made today. Owing to the loss we have suffered, I am compelled to await the arrival of reinforcements. But we certainly shall take possession of Lang's Neck eventually. And I sincerely hope that all those men who have so nobly done their duty today will be with me then.
Colonel.
Three cheers for General Colley. Remove helmets. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Aan meneer S.P.A. Creer, vice-president, waarde heer. Zoals ik in mijn laatste verslag gemeld heb, had ik enige ogenblik een aanval verwacht. En dat het 7 uur die ochtend plaatsvond. Ons het verbeterde gevecht. 24 van ons beste mannen het in die slag gebleven. Onder wie die zoon van voortrekker Dirk Huys. Aan die kant van die vijand was daar 109 dood en gewond. En de raas, commandant-generaal P. Joubert, meekse plaats, Vrijdag 28 januari 1881.
Dearest Edith, I am too tired and too sad to write much. My dear friend, Colonel Dean. Dead? His poor wife. Lieutenant Ellis and Major Poole, all killed together. And the ambulances and the wounded still passing me every minute. I, of course, must accept the verdict of failure. Since I wrote you last, I've had a severe setback, the loss of the Battle of Lang's Neck. I have suffered terribly in this last action. Of my original staff, few are left. There seems to be a fatality about everyone connected with me. I've certainly underestimated the enemy.
General Colley, sir. Reports just to hand indicate that the Burghers are again daily strengthening their position at Lang's Neck.
This means, sir, that another frontal attack on the neck is almost impossible.
For the past few days, I've been formulating another plan. To the left of Lang's Neck, there's a table-topped hill called Majuba. The summit is 6,500 feet above sea level. That's about 2,500 feet above our camp. This hill stands directly above the enemy position at the neck. I intend to seize the crest of the Majuba under cover of darkness, and from there mount an attack. Gentlemen, detail the following force to leave camp tonight at 10 o'clock. 3 companies, 92nd Highlanders, 2 companies, 60th Rifles, 2 companies, 58th Regiment, and the Naval Detachment, under Commander Romilly.
Sir.
And order the removal of bright helmet plates.
Yes, sir.
I see the General's kept his promise. The 58th, we're going to have another go.
Tell me, why didn't he wait for Evelyn Wood's reinforcements?
Rifles here, and instruct Captain Robertson to dig in and await further orders.
Sir.
Major Fraser.
Sir.
All horses will be left with Captain Robertson. From here on, we march.
Stuart, as soon as the men are on top, get them out to their positions.
Shall we build some form of defense, sir?
No. No, I don't think so, Stuart. Let them rest.
I overheard. We can cover the perimeters, but surely we can dig in.
You heard the order.
But, sir, why didn't we bring the rocket tubes and the guns?
Mevrou, is u baie seker hierdie Engels by Majuba sien uitklim?
Die Engelse se roete was oor die Inkwela berg en langs die kant van Majuba op.
Kon wildspokke ook gewees het. Gee toe, dit was baie donker.
Generaal, van wanneer af dra bokke rooi baaikies?
Kolonel Smit.
Maar
soek vir die vrijwilligers uit om die berg te bestorm. Verdeel hulle in 3 commando's. Hulle heerskap, commandant Roosmalan en Ferreira. Gejaag die Engelse by die berg van die duiven af.
Ja,
Joe, lovely to spend a Sunday morning, eh?
I'd rather spend it with a wee bit of skirt down in Maritzburg.
Oh, I don't know, Joe. If it snows, you can always go skiing, eh?
My name's Carter, war correspondent. Building yourself some cover?
Yes, sir.
That won't stop much.
It's good enough for what we shall need up here, sir.
Shall we start digging ourselves in, sir?
That's not necessary, Stuart. Our position is impregnable. Nothing short of hunger could turn us off the Majuba Mountain.
Hold the fort, laddie!
Aye, sir.
The Highlanders are under intense fire on the perimeter. The enemy are attacking in force.
Thank you, Mr. Hamilton. You will hold the position until further orders.
On my part to have come up and asked you.
No presumption, Mr. Hamilton. But we'll wait until they advance on us. Then we'll give them a volley and a charge.
General, the Engels is verslaan.
Do you know Mr. Colley?
I know General Colley, the governor of Natal in the Transvaal.
Yes, the governor. Are you certain you know him?
Yes, I'm certain. Why?
Come with me.
Is that the general? Yes.
Are you quite sure?
I give you my word of honor. That is the body of Sir George Pomeroy Colley. You've killed the bravest gentleman on the field today.
Carter, I've just come from General Dupin. I've got a copy of a message he sent to Lady Colley in Peter Maritzburg. Regret extremely sad fate of General Colley, who lost the battle and fell in action at 1 o'clock, February the 27th, in attempting to hold Mountain Fortress, forming right of enemy position. Regret also he should have fallen in a war, the outcome of a policy which he has not caused. Signed, B.J. Dupin. Oh, by the way, Jabert's called a conference of all correspondents at 11 o'clock at his camp tomorrow morning. As it is possible you may be misunderstood in England, is there anything you care to state for publication?
We won this fight. I do not think that if the truth came from our side, it would be believed. War will continue.
Although defeated, the British will fight on. There'll be reinforcements. They can't always be losing.
They go on to the Transvaal as beaten and destroyed.
Of course, they can't destroy the Transvaal. But they will fight on until you lay down your arms.
We want peace. But if necessary, we will die. All, every one of us, for our liberty.
Seize the Majuba Mountain. And I leave this behind in case I should not return to tell you how very dearly I love you and what happiness you have been to me. Don't let all life be dark to you if I don't come back. It's a strange world of chances, and the wrong card may turn up at any time. Think of our happiness together and our love, and let that be a source of comfort and light in your future life.